Okay. This is the final chapter for how I'm modeling on animation into Stellaris. We have worked in two sessions how I export, how I do textures on my model, and how I get all these stuff into the Stellaris mod you created. This time is the question, can I animate something like it is animated in vanilla? Or maybe much more strange. Yeah, you can. It's in the end, you have no limits for this. It's just that you make it correct. So we need to follow step by step exactly how it means with this exporter. You see here the final stage. I tested it, I ran it, and it worked. So I just do these steps I already did with the well-known cube, that we stay on the same asset, that you are not confused. Okay, so the final is that we have here on the side a time frame where we can visually see the animation. This blue line is the animation, and when we click here it's not working here. It's working in this way. Yeah, it's a new Blender. Yeah, you know. Okay, you see, it's a rotation animation, which means that with each frame, it's rotate clockwise when you look from above. Yeah, and this means the angle, and the angle you can read in degrees on the side here. 0 degrees, 50 degrees, 100 degrees, and so on, until 360. That means rotating 360. Okay? So, and I limited it to 179 frames. So you can see the full animation here. This is the stopping cube, which we exported last time, exactly at this moment I started, and I gave him an animation, which is the music maybe a bit loud. Give me a second. Okay, so it's better. So, I gave him an animation. Exactly at the moment we stopped at the last course, the last session. So I limit the animation time to 179 frames. It's usually by 250, so you need to take into account this change. This is important. You maybe also can make 360 seconds, so I choose 180, not seconds, frames. I choose 180. It's even, yeah. But I make it simple. I take a circle, and half it by and cut it by half, or quarter it, or double it. So it's simple to calculate the decrease to the frames. So I know by 180 frames, it's 2 degrees per one frame. Quite simple. Make no complicated stuff. Make it simple. 2 degrees per one frame. And this has happened then. Now, why I didn't make 180? Why I didn't make 179. This is The very first frame is this one, where it's exactly north. Yeah, you have exact the exact. I have no idea how it's called in English. It's meaning it's a perfect sitting in this clear position. Okay, and when you have it a full turn by 360, it's exactly the same position as it is in frame one. It's exactly the same position. That means that you not need the very last frame. I cut the very last frame and say on the very last position here. On the very last position 358 degrees. Yeah? Think about that. This is important. The next frame, the very next frame in this linear progress would be 360. But 360 is also zero. But you will have a closed circle. This closed circle starts automatically when you implemented it correct. Automatically pass again and again and again. And as you see, it's a perfect smoothing transition from the end to the beginning. Bap. You don't see anything that it's starting from the beginning. That is making it perfect. This is important for a not stuttering animation. Yeah? Keep it simple. Make just rotations at start. Make just rotations at start. Okay, so I will show you what you get as animation when you start. So we will. I need to explain the animation stuff before we making maybe something strange with the bones and so. Let's join in animation stuff here. This is a gun. So it's gone. Yeah? Okay. I go over to my bone. Yeah. I delete the animation. I go to the very first frame. Check numblock 7, looking above, taking my rotation. Okay, so very first position I need to save. I press I, as you see here, I, yeah, and I choose location and rotation, lock rot. This is lock rot scale, this is lock scale. Yeah, you can in different combinations saved, but we just need location and the rotation. Other stuff we don't need right now, maybe at some times. I have no idea if scaling working in Stellaris, but it could be interesting. So bam, I have set the very first keyframe here. Yeah, the very first keyframe. It's changed nothing. We just have a keyframe. We need a second keyframe over time to change anything. And so we go to the middle of 179. This means for funny point, not by half. It means 90. 90. I take my rotation here and give it 180 degrees. 180 degrees. Enter, press I, set lock rot, and you see you have a tangent curve. Yeah. And we don't care about this tangent curve. We go further to 179 and go on with rotation. And we think about what we said. One frame, 2 degrees, 360, 359, 358. Or 359. It's whatever. I guess the three. Yeah. Let me chip back. 3. This one. Okay. And pressing I lock rod. Oh, you see here. Wow. We have something made wrong. We have something made wrong. What we did wrong? No idea. Okay, good. 90 degrees, 180. 180. I lock rod. Rotation. 180. That's a point. That's a point. I'm stupid. Sorry, guys. Yeah, okay. 180 and 178. Yeah. Lock rod. Okay, this looks much better. So, when we now move on. Oh, they changed the combination here, what? Spacebar? Really? But you see, it's going fast. It's starting slow and moving to high speed and going slow back again. And this is anyway not looking as I wanted. Something is wrong. I made some mistakes here. Why am I making mistakes here? Now give me a check. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Okay. This pretty seems not to be on the correct position. Again. What I made wrong. 90. Rotate by 180. Save. Lock rod. Really? Okay, I'm confused. Okay, starts again. You see, it's a bit difficult. It worked perfectly in my test run, but now it's bap. Okay, again. I save start position. Start position is wrong. So, deleted. Start position. I lock rod. Okay, start position. End position. At 360. Wait a second. Okay, we go here 90. And go here 180. Save lock rod. We go to 179. And we go. Yeah. This looks much better now. Okay. And we have this problem, which I want to show you, that there is a tangent, and we change it with activate the curve, pressing T like zero, and changing from busy to linear. So we have a constant linear curve, and it should work exactly here. Not noticeable that it starts from the beginning again. Okay, we did it well. Finally. This is how you animate. This is all the stuff about the animation. You don't need more. Nobody needs... they think, oh, it's Tucker, I need more keyframes. Oh, oh, oh. No, you need just... new update. you just need the important points. The important point here is that you say it in what direction it moves, and this you clear up when you make in exactly the middle the contra point, and then you jump back. And this is it could happen when you make it to 180 exactly, that the same way is clockwise and against clockwise, contrawise. It could happen. It turns left around the halfway, and then the halfway right around. So this is also the point. You just go to the very last frame before 180, or before if its full circle is closed. Yeah, before full circle is closed, one frame before you must end. That in your animation it's not go reversed. Maybe not simple to understand, but it's a math thing. The shortened way is where it goes, and when you shorten a way in the right direction you want, then it goes correct. And when both ways, left and right away, is the same length, then you cannot control which side it goes. Maybe Blender is have it function, but in the earlier version it maybe joins backwards. So that's the point I say it. But how I get my amateur? This is also a point. How I get my amateur? As you see, we have here the cube, and suddenly we have here amateur stuff. How we get that? For this, we go back. Here we ended last time. So we have this visible, invisible cube. This we delete. How we get this amateur? For this, we go here to add and say amateur. Bam. There we have it. That's the amateur. I guess it's done. But I do always extrude with E and rotate 90 degrees. Always I do this, exactly this, for rotating. I just make sure that my armature have a direction that I can I can rotate it as I want, and this small thing maybe have no idea how it would have to rotate. So that's why I extrude. Okay, but when I rotate now, nothing happened. For this, you need to take all these stuff here. Click on armature with control. Press control P and empty with groups. And then it stick together, team. That's all. That's all. That's fucking all. Yeah? That's all. Now you're beginning here with animation stuff. Yeah. Yeah. Start lock rod. Rotate. Go to frame 50. Rotate. Lock rod, go to frame whatever. 150. Make exactly another thing with moving is working. And lock rod. And then go to the end. 250, which is zero, then here zero, and here zero, and here zero, and here zero, and lock rod. Then I have a full rotation. Let's check. And here you see why BC, so this tangent curve, is cool. It makes more natural. Yeah, it shows that it have a weight, it have a mass. Yeah, when I change it now to linear, it's more like a paper thing. Yeah, it's with of weight, and this is not cool. So pretty strange, at least, is the constant one. It's flipping, whoop. Yeah, I don't like that. But there are still another funny things like bones. There it's coming boom 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 boom. Yeah, for cool stuff you can make these with bouncy animations. So or startling. Elastic. Way. Way. Or the moving back is a bit. I don't like that. And so. Why, why, why? But I think as a space animation, it could be work. Why not? Why not? Yeah. What's cool stuff we have? This way, yeah. Yeah, why not? Yeah. And then we have circular. this is not the end in animation stuff. You still can take these and move it like something strange. As you want. Yeah, you can move it as you want. But you need to understand geometric of these curves, these lines. It's not simple. Yeah, I just will say it's like you don't, your brain think in that lines. You think, oh yeah, it's a cool curve, and you move it. Huh? What happened now? What I did? Yeah. It's not always to understand what is really, really. At least I would like to see this in Stellaris. So, why not? Okay. Let's take the cool stuff. Which was the coolest? How's that? Okay, we take it. We take this. We have this mesh. We just... yeah. What you need to export is with the mesh bone, yeah. So you get, yeah. But I have it. Yeah, just show it. It's working. So, and then you need to save the animation, and I take always the same name as I took for the mesh to not get. In confusing with the animation stuff, yeah, you have no visuals for next turn to understand what is what. Okay, export animation, whoop, and it worked. Okay, so let's go and now to the import stuff, the important stuff. This was the simple part. The simple part is to make the animation. The hard part is to implement the animation. It took me more time to figuring out how it's working. Yeah. Okay. As first, I will check my animation here and take the name and say Auric and go to here, my recent animation. Okay. Okay, the name, because I don't want to change the stuff here. I just want to watch how it looks strange with this animation, huh? So we go to Stellaris. And I have already prepared save game. What is Discord saying? Yeah. Nobody of you assholes joined me as while streaming live. Okay, I'm stopping live stream. So, anyway. I will hope the record is working. Stop record. Okay, sounds it's working. Ooh, this is not good. This flickering is not good. But it's from something. It's not from here. It's from here. This is something strange on the frame. But this is the animation we did. I just replaced the cube with the Corvette and taking over the original Corvette's diffuse because I lost the GFX for the cube. But don't care. We just want to work with animations here. And I like it. Yeah? Just to be clear, you can make ambient stuff which is pretty cool. And I really like to see that. Yeah. It's quite simple. It's quite simple. It's just to understand on which point I need to work. So it works. And we can watch it another hour. But how I do this fucking animation into the mod. This needs, as first, your updated mesh file. That's this one. With the bone, with the so-called rigged. So-called rigged means it's have its amateur, and this amateur rigged means not it's have animation. It just means it have bones. It's rigged. That you can make it animate. It's animated. It's exported. It's here. Yeah. This one. This one. I used this one, but as you see, the same size. Don't care. So this is my rigged cube, and I have an animation. I have other animation which I made. It's just circling around, like for the bases. Yeah, and just show you this example, and we can watch later the other example. It's not. Don't care about the example. It's just that it working. The animation have to be dropped to here or in any dedicated folder. You can make it as a dedicated folder, as you see by Federation and so on. They are sorted in folders. But then you need to know, I have a subfolder, I have to take care. Then, you need the GFX file of the mesh file. You need the asset file of the GFX file. And you need the asset file, and you need the asset file of the animations. As first, the animation. Take the name, .anim. Go to here, copy this, I'll show you. I pass the name in, copied this part, I doubled it, I replace the file name, I replace the animation name. Done. What is done happen? Ah, yeah, underline, not dot, yeah. This is my save point. Then, going to the GFX file of the mesh file. Yeah, this is all I did, yeah, I changed in HAL to HAL main, and taking over the diffuse, as I said. And then, I make me space, and put in, paste and copy from vanilla, animation equals bracket ID equals idle. This is the important part, idle. Type Ferengi blah 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 animation stuff and so on. And then I change the type name. Yeah? The type name is the important stuff here. You took in that the idle animation will taking the animation you called in the animation assets. here. Yeah? This call the dot the file. Yeah? Okay. That's the way to go. Then you have to go to the chips. Check where is your ship. This is my ship. Make me space. Taken again from the vanilla file. The default state is equals idle. Important. Default state equal idle. State is equals bracket name idle. And then animation idle. Animation plan time means you can scale the time. You can scale the animation duration. Yeah, you can make it longer and shorter. That the animation it took maybe 179 frames. But you can say take it 1 second or take it 10 seconds. This is what it means here. Yeah. And I guess one means here 100% speed. So maybe you can 100% speed to 0% speed. So you can scale up and down a bit. Just play with it. Yeah, you can play with the time. That's all. When you have done this, when you have the GFX file, the animations asset, and the ships asset, you have placed the mesh file with the bone, with the armature. You have the exported animation. It's done. It's done. That's all. This is the way how it goes. So, for example, taking this my other animation, make it here .1. Okay, and going back to where is Steam here? I always jump back to the save game. It's loading faster than, and this loading here in Windows, so annoying. I need to say the save game loadings are not so bad, but the very first loading, it's by 5 times longer as on Linux. The very first loading is pretty bad. Yep. And here you see my animation for my test before I started recording. Yeah. That's all. So, just wait a second. Maybe the asset file animation should reload assets. This should work. Up to 10 seconds. This freeze in Linux. No idea how long this takes. It feels much longer than 10 seconds. Did it change? It feels not. Maybe it's not working. Maybe it needs a reload of the game. Oh, we will try it. So anyway, Anyway, you know it is for the animation speed, so you can set it. Maybe it's not working with Acid Reloaded. By the way, Acid Reloaded it's didn't working to me very well in last versions of Stellaris. Yeah. Yeah, ignore that part. That's all. Now you can export animations. Yeah? Isn't cool. I really hope this will result in pretty awesome stuff. Just tell me what you think about these workshops, and tell me ideas about the next topic. Have a nice, great modding. Have a nice, great day. And comment.